Let's talk about when you might want to use a differential amplifier, and then we'll design one. A differential amplifier, as you might recall, is an amplifier that takes two inputs and then it amplifies the difference between the two inputs. That's unlike a standard amplifier that might only have one input and then just give you a larger version of that input. Consider a transducer. This could be, for example, a temperature transducer, a temperature sensor, something that produces a very small signal between these two pins coming out of it. This could represent any small signal, really, and what we intend to do is to amplify that small signal. Let's first consider the situation if you use a normal amplifier. A normal amplifier made from an op amp with a controllable gain could, for example, be the one that I'm showing right now. What's a problem with this configuration? Well, a problem can occur when we think about the noise that might be picked up along the signal path between the transducer and the amplifier. Anytime you have a long piece of wire, it always behaves like an antenna. It can pick up interference from the environment. Radio waves are passing around all over the place. These radio waves can be picked up by this wire. If you have a very small signal along your line, say a millivolt, and you intend to amplify that signal, then you don't want the interference to overwhelm your signal. The problem with the current configuration is that your op amp is going to amplify both the signal and the noise. One way to remedy this problem would be to take note that any noise in the environment will be picked up by not only the signal line, but also by the return line or the ground path. The way we have it set up, the signal is encoded in the difference between these two wires, but the noise is common to both of them. Therefore, we can use a differential amplifier to just amplify the difference. Let's see how we might go about doing that. Let's first create a more precise mathematical model of our line interference. We're just going to model it as a common mode signal. This VCM here is going to represent the signal that we don't want to amplify. This is how we're going to model our interference. This representation of the circuit might allow you to see more clearly why we can't use a normal amplifier. You see, if we use a normal amplifier, the voltage at this pin will represent both the signal from the transducer and the common mode signal. The amplifier will again amplify both of these signals, but that's not what we want. Using a differential amplifier can remedy that problem. The circuit that you're seeing right now is an example differential amplifier. The purpose of this particular amplifier is to amplify the signal from the transducer while rejecting the common mode voltage sources that you're seeing. In other words, what we want is for the output voltage to depend only upon the difference between V1 and V2. We don't want the output voltage to depend upon either V1 or V2 alone, because in such a situation, it would depend upon the common mode voltage. Let's now analyze the differential amplifier that I've just drawn and see if we can make this condition come true. Before I get started here with the derivation, I do want to point out that this amplifier is not perfect, and we're going to develop more suitable differential amplifiers in subsequent videos. For one thing, the input impedance is not as high as possible. We're not looking directly into the op amp, we're looking through some resistors. Along this line as well, we're not looking directly into the pin of the op amp, we're looking through some resistors that are connected to ground. The input impedance, therefore, is not as high as the input impedance of the op amp itself. That's something that we can improve upon in future videos. It's a drawback of this circuit, but I want to start with this circuit because it's not a very complicated differential amplifier, as you'll see in a moment. It does have some other drawbacks as well. We'll get to those in just a moment. Let's start off by finding the common mode gain of this amplifier. I've drawn VCM, or the common mode signal, attached to both of these input pins. If the amplifier is working as desired, the output voltage ought to be zero. Let's see what it is. I'm going to call this voltage V, and if the op amp is giving us a stable output voltage, then the voltage here at the inverting pin also should be V. Let's label this current I1 and this current I2. We'll assume an ideal op amp, so there shouldn't be any current branching off into the inverting pin, therefore I1 should equal I2. I1 can be found by applying Ohm's law across R1, and I2 can be found by applying Ohm's law across R2. Let's now write V in terms of VCM. Since there won't be any current going into the non-inverting pin of the op amp, this is just a voltage divider. Let's now multiply both sides of this equation by R2. Let's now rearrange terms in order to isolate VO. I can now substitute for V. I notice that this term is just 1 over 1 plus R3 over R4. At this point, I have the output voltage in terms of VCM, the common mode voltage. So I can isolate the common mode gain. It's the output voltage divided by the common mode voltage. You might recall here that our goal is to create a differential amplifier that doesn't have any common mode gain at all. Therefore, what I'm going to do now is to consider how we might eliminate this ACM. I'll show you the answer, and then I'll prove to you that it's the correct answer. The answer is that if R2 over R1 equals R4 over R3, then the common mode gain is zero. Let's verify that through substitution. When I get to R3 over R4, I'm just going to write R1 over R2. Let's rewrite the first term, and then when we look at this fraction on the right, I'm going to expand it out in both the numerator and the denominator. Up there at the top, we have R1 plus R2, and down here at the bottom, we also have R2 plus R1. These terms cancel, and the second term just becomes R2 over R1, that's zero. As you can see, the common mode gain for this particular amplifier is zero, but only if R2 over R1 equals R4 over R3. Therefore, when we design our differential amplifier, that's what we need to do. I've already explained one of our drawbacks, that this particular amplifier has a low input impedance. Let's now look at the third drawback, that the effect of the common mode voltage on the output voltage depends on resistor variability in the op-amp common mode rejection ratio. If you look at our common mode gain, you'll notice that it depends on all of the resistors. Even if I set R2 divided by R1 to R4 divided by R3, it doesn't mean that those resistors are actually going to be identical. If R2 is equal to R4 and R1 is equal to R3, then the common mode gain will indeed be zero. But as you know, when you pull resistors out of the rack, there can be some variation from one resistor to another. There might be a 1% difference between resistors. So if your resistors are not perfectly matched, then the common mode gain might not be zero. That's why I say that the common mode gain might depend a little bit on resistor variability. Of course, it also depends on the op-amp's common mode rejection ratio itself. As for the fact that the gain cannot be adjusted easily, our second drawback, I'm going to have to actually calculate the gain. All we've done so far is to calculate the common mode gain. But what about the differential gain? Our goal here is to design a differential amplifier, and presumably we would like to be able to control the gain of it, right? So let's take this amplifier, assume that the common mode gain is zero, and let's calculate what our differential gain is going to be. Let's now draw a differential voltage source. This could be a transducer, for example. Any environmental interference would be picked up by both of these lines and would show up as a common mode signal. But we've already designed the amplifier to reject that common mode signal. So now we're only interested in the differential signal V sub D, the signal from our transducer. Why have I drawn it upside down here? Well, the reason I've drawn it upside down is just because our op amp here has the non-inverting pin at the lower side. Our common ground is defined as the common ground of the amplifier. So let's go ahead and draw the ground symbol over here. Remember, this is just a mathematical ground. It's not a real ground. Our goal here is going to be to find A sub D, the differential gain. And that's defined as the output divided by the differential input. Let's get started with our derivation here. Let's call this I sub 1, and let's call this current I sub 2. Let's label this voltage V, and if the op amp is working as we expect it to, then this voltage should also be the same V. First of all, these two currents ought to be equal to one another. Let's find these two currents through Ohm's law. Here's V over R for I1, and here's V over R for I2. For our second equation, I notice that there's a voltage divider here. V is just some fraction of V sub D. Let's now substitute in our condition that allowed the common mode gain to be zero. This is then R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Let's multiply everything times R2 to continue our derivation here. Let's now rearrange terms so that we have the output voltage by itself, and we can now group the V terms together. Let's rewrite that fraction as R1 plus R2 divided by R1. And now for this V, I'm going to substitute in our equation 2. We have some cancellation here, giving us a very nice and simple output voltage. This completes our derivation of the differential gain. The output voltage divided by the input voltage is just R2 over R1. One thing that I'd like you to notice is that if we make all four resistors the same, say R, then it's going to be a unity gain differential amplifier. That is to say the differential gain would be 1 and the common mode gain would be 0. Practically, even with this amplifier, the overall common mode rejection ratio is still going to be limited by that of the op amp itself. But as you can see, it's already a very decent differential amplifier. Now let's go back to the other limitation or the other drawback of the circuit. I want to draw your attention to the fact that it's not so easy to adjust the gain. Why have I said that the gain cannot be easily adjusted? We just found an equation for it. It's just R2 divided by R1. Can't we just change either R2 or R1 in order to adjust the gain? Well, although R2 and R1 look like single resistors in this equation, practically speaking, there are two resistors whenever I have one written. For example, let's say I wanted to raise the gain. Looking at the equation, I should just increase R2. But looking at the circuit, we have to increase resistor R2, but we also have to increase resistor R4 because R4 equals R2. That's why the gain is difficult to change, because if I wanted to increase the gain, I have to increase the resistance of two resistors simultaneously. You would have to gang the resistors together, and sometimes that's not always practical. In the next video, I'm going to be looking at a more sophisticated differential amplifier called an instrumentation amplifier that helps out with all three of these drawbacks as we've seen with this particular differential amplifier.